Hello, Mrs. Rogers? No? Oh, I must be in the wrong house. So from now on, we're going to do things my way. For a start, David Hockney's going to design the bombs, and I've seen
that
the
plans. That must be the new gas cooker!
Morning, Mrs. G. Crump.
No, Mrs. G. Pinnett.
This is 46 Edgington Crescent.
No, Road, Edgington Road.
Road, yeah, it says here, yeah. Right, could I speak to Mrs. G. Crump, please?
Oh, does nobody hear of that name? It's Mrs. G. Pinnett, 46 Edgington Road.
Well, it says Crump here, done it, Harry?
Yeah, it's on the invoice.
Yeah, it's definitely Crump.
Well, there must have been a mistake, because the address is right, and that's definitely the cooker I ordered, the blue and white cookies.
Well, you can't have this. This is Crump.
Oh, dear, what are we going to do?
Well, I don't know. What we can do for you is take it back to the depot, get a transfer slip from Crump to Pinnett, put it on a special delivery.
Yeah, that's best. We'll special it for you. We'll get it down there today and you get it back in 10 weeks.
Yeah.
10 weeks? Mummy, can't just leave this one?
What, this?
What, leave it here?
Yes.
Well, I don't know. I suppose we could.
Oh, but you'd have to fill out a temporary dispatch note, wouldn't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, we could leave it on a temporary dispatch note.
Well, that's sorted out then.
Yeah.
What a mess, isn't it?
Oh, no, it's ridiculous, really, but there you are. Glad we could be such a help. Right, would you sign it down there, please, Mrs. Crump?
Pin it.
Pin it, yeah. Listen, just for the books, make it a bit easier. Could you sign it Crump in it?
What?
Right, thank you very much, dear. The cooker's yours.
Oh. Yep, here we go.
Right. Sorry about the bother, but there you are, you know. Cheerio.
Cheerio, Mrs. Crump.
Excuse me. Hey! Can you put it in the kitchen?
You what?
Well, I can't cook on it unless it's connected up.
Oh, we didn't realise you had an installation invoice.
An MI?
No, we can't touch it without an MI, you see.
4R16. If it's a special. No, it's not special. That's back at the depot.
No, special's the same as installation invoice.
So it's an R16.
What's an installation invoice?
Pink form from Reading.
Oh, we wondered what that was. These are the four.
That's the one, love. Yeah, this should be all I need. This. Hang on. This is for Pinnett, Mrs. G. Pinnett.
Oh, that's right, I'm Mrs. G. Pinnett.
Well, we got Crump Pinnett on the invoice.
Well, shall I sign it Crump Pinnett then?
No, not an MI, no.
No, that's from area service at Reading. Yeah.
No, Cheltenham, isn't it?
No, not this side of the street.
Look, I just want it connected up.
Well, what about London office?
No, I haven't got the machinery.
Not now.
What, Hounslow Depot?
Ah, they're still on standard pressure.
Same with Twickenham.
But surely they can connect up a gas cooker.
Oh, yeah, we can connect it up, love, but not unless it's an emergency.
Well, this is an emergency.
No, it's not. Emergencies are 290, where there is actual or apparent loss of combustible gaseous substances.
Yeah, it's like a leak.
Yeah.
Or a 478.
No, that's valve adjustment.
Well, it can't be a leak unless you've connected it up.
No, quite. We'd have to turn it on.
Well, can't you turn it on and connect it up?
No. But what we can do, and this is between you and me, I shouldn't really be telling you this, we'll turn your gas on, make a hole in your pipe, you ring Hounslow Emergency, they'll be round here in a couple of days.
Well, the house full of gas at the depot, then!
Oh, wow! In that case, you'd have Southeast Area manager round here, like a shot.
Really?
Oh, yes, one or more person overcome by fumes, you'd have head office open round here.
Really?
Yeah, that's murder, you see.
Or suicide.
No, that's S42.
Oh. Still, I thought it was Hangall.
No, Central Area and Southall Marking Division, they're both on the S42 now.
And they'd be able to connect it up.
Oh, they'd do the lot for you, lad.
And they'd come out this afternoon.
Well, what is it now? 11:30, murder. They'd be round here by 2.
Oh, well, that's wonderful.
Oh, well, right, love, you like to lie down here?
All right.
Okay, Harry.
Okay, gas on.
Right, deep breath, love. Ring head office, would you, Norman?
Shall I go through maintenance?
No, you better go through Deptford maintenance.
Well, pack them on a 207.
That's the palace now.
That's lotion, yes.
What about Tarpon?
B44.
Not
a
B44.
Parking, isn't it?
That's Clapham Junction.
Well, Lewisham.
Tell us down.
It's central,
isn't
it? Yes.
All the roads, isn't it? There.
In 1940,
1943, a group of British Army officers working deep behind enemy lines carried out one of the most dangerous and heroic raids in the history of warfare. But that's as may be. And now...
Go in. What do you want?
I'd like to leave the army, please, sir.
Good heavens, man, why?
It's dangerous.
What?
There are people with guns out there, sir.
What?
Real guns, sir, not proper ones, sir, not toy ones, sir, proper ones, sir. They've all got them. All of them, sir. And some of them have got tanks.
Watkins, they are on our side.
And grenades, sir, and machine guns, sir. So I'd like to leave, sir, before I get killed, please.
Watkins, you've only been in the army a day.
I know, sir, but people get killed. Properly dead, sir. No Barney cross fingers, sir. A boat was telling me, if you're in the army and there's a war, you have to go and fight.
That's true.
Well, I mean, blimey, I mean, if it was a big war, somebody could be hurt.
Watkins, why did you join the army?
For the water skiing and for the travel, sir. Not for the killing, sir. I asked them to put it on my form, sir. No killing.
Watkins, are you a pacifist?
No, sir, I'm not a pacifist, sir. I'm a coward.
That's a very silly line. Sit down.
Yes, it's silly.
Awfully bad.
Two civilian gentlemen to see you, sir!
Show them in, please, Sergeant.
Mr. Dino Facotti and Mr. Luigi Facotti!
Morning, Colonel.
Morning, gentlemen. Now, what can I do for you?
You've got a nice army base there, Colonel.
Yes.
We wouldn't want anything to happen to it.
What?
No, what my brother means is it would be a shame if I...
Oh, sorry, Colonel.
Well, don't worry about that, but please do sit down.
No, we prefer to stand, thank you, Colonel.
All right, but what do you want?
What do we want? Very good, Colonel.
Colonel's a joker, Luigi.
Explain it to the Colonel, Dino.
How many tanks you got, Colonel?
About 500 altogether.
500, eh?
You ought to be careful, Colonel.
We are careful. Extremely careful.
Cause things break, don't they?
Break?
Well, everything breaks, don't it, Colonel? Oh, there.
Oh, I see my brother's clumsy, Colonel. When he gets unhappy, he breaks things. Like, say, don't feel the army's playing fair by him. He may start breaking things, Colonel.
Look, what is all this about?
How many men you got here, Colonel?
Oh, 7,000 infantry, 600 artillery, and two divisions of paratroops.
Paratroops, Dino?
Oh, best shame if someone was to set fire to them.
Yeah. Set fire to them?
Fires happen, Colonel.
Things burn.
Look, what is all this about?
My brother and I got a little proposition for you, Colonel.
God save you, a lot of bother.
I mean, you're doing all right here, aren't you, Colonel?
But suppose some of your tanks was to get broken, your troops started getting lost, fights started breaking out during general inspection, like.
That wouldn't be good for business, would it, Colonel?
Are you threatening me?
No.
Whatever made you think that, Colonel? The
Colonel doesn't think we're nice people, Louis.
We're your buddies, Colonel.
We want to look after you.
Look after me?
We can guarantee you that not a single armoured division will get done over for 15 bob a week.
No, this is silly.
What's silly?
No, the whole premise is silly and it's very badly written. I'm the senior officer here and I haven't had a funny line yet, so I'm stopping you. You can't be. I've done it. The sketch is over.
I want to leave the army, please, sir. It's dangerous.
Look, I stopped your sketch 5 minutes ago, so get out of shot. Right, director, close up. Zoom in on me. That's better.
It's only because you couldn't think of a punchline.
Not true, not true. It's time for the cartoon. Cue telecine. 10, 9, 8...
Our general public's not going to understand this, are they?
Shut up, you eye-ties!